Hey guys, Twa's back. I'm just getting over a cold, which I know is summer, which so it's complete bullshit that I had some sort of illness. So if my throat sounds a little shaky over the mic, that's why. Anyways, let's get back to this. Oh, my TV's so low, I can't hear shit. Okay.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on. The visitor center was sturdy, but the impact turned the front of the building into splinters. Rusty was thrown across the lobby like a rag doll and hit the far wall hard. It didn't hurt until he tried to move and saw his leg bend it wrong way. Felt the broken rib stabbing him on the inside. Rusty howled in pain and fear, suddenly afraid to die alone.
I always do this. Okay. Yeah, unlock that door.
At the last instant, I changed direction and threw myself down. The axe splintered the trunk of a tree. I stumbled into the pool of bright light. My lungs burned. I was too exhausted to move. I tensed as I waited for the killing blow, but it never came. I raised my head. Nothing moved in the darkness beyond. For the moment, bathed in the cold light, I was safe.
Well, that's a good sign. Nothing's back here.
Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Well, that's a problem.
Rusty! Rusty!
The ground was covered with broken patches that looked like liquid darkness.
Getting rid of all this shit.
Hunters need hunting licenses.
I'm cheap. I don't want to go to the supermarket to get more batteries.
Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Please!
Don't feed the animals!
I remember this fight being bullshit.
Fishing! For those
prisoners
who purchase a park license! No pay! At all times! Rusty? Rusty, no!
Yep, pretty bullshit.
Two bears and wolves never approach any other closer than 25 yards. Never leave your pet on a
tender. Look at this shit. He hides in his house. Motherfucker will not stand still. Yes! My god. I could use some more guns now. Ominous.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
New manuscript.
In that last instant of consciousness, Rusty thought about Rose. He was older than she was. Rose was barely out of her teens. But she made him feel young and forget what a train wreck his on-date marriage had been. He still wore the ring. He'd been waiting for her to tell him to take it off. Now she never would.
That's sad. Oh, who gets sick in the summer? It's never happened to me before. What's that sign say? For your safety, stay on the designated hiking trail.
Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
I know there's one of those secret chest thingies at the end of this place. Moonshine Cave. This cave was a site of frequent and lucrative bootlegger activity throughout the Prohibition 1919-1933. It was mostly used for temporary storage of alcohol smuggled from Canada, but at times alcohol was also distilled on the premises. Yes. Shotgun, thank God. I don't have any ammo for it, but once I get some, it'll be a little bit more useful. Wait, sorry, my ear was itching. wow, where'd he come from? Still say Alan has no adrenaline.
Nobody in Bright Falls seemed to know where Al was, but Rose, the waitress at the diner, had seen him. From what Baron could tell, Al pretty much fell off the face of the earth when he left the diner. Rose was just the kind of fan that Al hated, but she really tried to help. She was smart, too. Knew a lot about what was going on in the town. Knew a lot about Al. Even knew who Barry was. Barry liked her. That was no big surprise. When it came to women, Barry and Al rarely saw eye to eye.
Hazard. You think the big waterfall would be a marked hazard? Okay. You see, this is the kind of things where you want to know if you can fall down, but you don't want to because you don't feel like dying. The game should just tell you. So you can fall down here. Yep, I feel a fight coming on. I totally have no idea if I'm going the right way at the moment. Ow. Get out of here. Get out of here. Places like this where there's enemies all over the place, I do not like. Oh, I just ran into him. And not one of my brighter moments. One of them. Finally, a chest. Maybe some shotgun ammo.
I turned the corner, afraid of what the flashlight's beam might reveal. Suddenly, a roughly painted symbol of a torch glowed in the light. Behind it, hidden by a rock, sat a battered metal trunk. It was here for a reason. Packed with supplies, batteries, flares, ammo. Things you need to make it through the darkness of the night. Something left behind by someone who knew what I knew, and more.
I wonder who that could be. You know, this axe bitch is really starting to piss me off. Yep, I remember this fight being bull cunt. Look at this bitch, oh god. Fucking die. Fuck, I forget how to dodge. No, I forget how to dodge. No! I'm really gonna have to remember how to dodge, because I really cannot remember. This is what you get for not playing the game. So I was sick. Alright, with this checkpoint, I'm going to let you guys go. See you next episode.